beautiful lap with you. But before we start,
well, hang on a minute. Why do you keep saying B?
Because we are talking about
B.
Buzz off! You've had your turn. This is how it all began.
Anything to see from the Bee Centre and feel them inspired is all so much that the teachers throw all their plans and replan lots of quizzy activities. We are going to explain to you how truly important bees are. Firstly, you had better meet the beekeeper.
They use also a spinner that you put
in and that helps all the honeycomb escape the frame. Then you need to put all the honey into a sieve to get all the wax out, and then you put it in the jar to leave.
These are amazing creatures that are very special to the world. If they weren't alive, most of our favourite bees would be gone.
The process of making honey is hard for the bees. First of all, bees fly from far to far, collecting nectar with their very long tongues. The nectar goes into a special honey stomach called a crop.
The nectar is made with two sugars and water. Whereas in the bee's stomach, enzymes start to break down the nectar into two sugars.
The bees pass the nectar from a honey stomach to another bee, and so on. This continues to break down the nectar.
Once complete, the honey bees put their nectar into the hexagonal wax cell, and they flap their wings to evaporate the water.
Did you know that bees can fly up to 25 miles per hour?
Did you know that the queen bee can lay over 2,000 eggs a day?
Did you know that worker honey bees are similar shapes and size to wasps?
How dare they! I'm nothing like an ugly old wasp. Now set them down and listen. See, trying to prevent this from happening.
As I was saying, worker honey bees are similar shapes and size to wasps. However, honeybees have black legs while wasps have yellow legs.
When a worker brings a new source of nectar, she comes back to the hive and does our waggle dance. Tell them where it is. This is our waggle dance we are learning in our dance lessons.
When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing,
babies.
Did you know that bees pollinate more than 250,000 species?
apple flowers won't go into apples, and there wouldn't be seeds to go into new carrots.
We wouldn't start without bees, but we have to eat much more rice, pasta and bread. A healthy diet will become much more expensive, and some people might not be able to afford it.
Without bees, there would be no pizza, chips, crisps, juice, or most types of fruit and vegetables. There'll be hardly any birds, even so food will be less tasty.
In pear orchards in China, there are so few bees that people need to pollinate the pears by hand. They climb through the trees with pollination sticks made out of chicken feathers, dip the sticks into bottles of pollen, and touch the sticks to each of the billions of blossoms.
About 50% of bee hives have been transported to California to pollinate orchards.
It's a good job we have lots of bees here in the UK then.
Well, actually, did you know the bee population in the UK is dramatically reduced?
Why?
We've lost 9-10% of our wildflower meadows. They have been turned into farmland to grow food for people. Bigger fields are worse for bees because nesting sites get pushed to the edges.
How's the supermarkets, offices and roads have also been built on wildflower meadows?
Scientists are finding that chemicals are affecting bees' health when they feed on plants, sprayed or treated with pesticides. There are also pests and diseases that weaken bees.
The weather has an effect too. More changeable weather is causing floods, droughts, high winds. Also, the weather can be, when temperature can be warmer than colder than normal. All this makes life more difficult for bees.
Teachers have gone bee mad. In science this top term we've been learning about plants. We planted dwarfs and flowers and a variety of wildflower seeds because bees love them.
We have painted how the sunflowers might look.
Did you know? We have used our math skills to measure and create bar charts.
Listening to our BSM Bee League. We hope you enjoyed it.